Hello everyone, this is Matt the Speedstar, aka the Game Rebel here, ready to run through the next part of The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. So, we got three shrines done last time. I was actually surprised that I was able to get the shrine on Tingle Island, the Kamale Shrine, and the shrine quest into the Vortex done so quickly. I mean, if I took the long way around and actually did the spiral, I would have taken up the entire video's length. Because of that, we were also able to go into the Eternally Dark Typhlo Ruins. I assume that's how it's pronounced because the first part reminds me of Typhoon. But we got that done. The Keto Wawai Shrine is also done. I really hope I never have to go back in there, because if so, I am going to be upset. Because believe me, it is very hard to get around in there, and I don't really want to have to... I really should start cashing some of my Korok seeds and get more weapon slots. And I'm probably going to do that after the next Korok hunt. Anyway, since you already can tell that the travel medallion's been set up here, as opposed to where I have it set up for getting Nadra stuff, I think you know what I'm going to be doing. A quick heads up, though... This is probably one of the most boring and tedious shrine quests to do, so if you are not interested in this at all, I don't blame you. I really don't. Grab some warm Saflina. Oh right, they don't have cool Saflina. I stand corrected. But I'm also here first because I did a quick little bit of prep work. Anyway. So that quick prep work is essentially upgrading my climbing gear, which I got at the shrine on Tinoco Island. So that way I have the climbing sets set bonus. I figure I might as well show it off, because I might get this done a little quick. I don't know. It just depends on how I manage to do this, because believe me, I've only ever done... this once. And by once, I mean the shrine quest that we're doing, which is the Seven Heroines. Anyway, I also had to get a couple of electric key swings and hightail lizards, and that was my prep work, pretty much. Hightail lizards are easy to come by, because all you gotta do is just take out a one-handed sword and continuously spin attack. You'll find hightail lizards easy. And you won't kill them either. Alright, with this, we will finally get the set bonus that I have been waiting for a long time. Set bonus, climbing jump, stamina up. Which, I think I described it before. It's like the swim bonus that you get with the Zora armor. Except for when you're jumping while you're climbing. I got it specifically for this, and well, possibly other things. Now, I'm pretty sure I cannot enhance it again. I cannot. I need hot-footed frogs and ice key swings. Ice key swings are a little harder to come by because there's not that many ice keys around. I'd have to actually go up to Mount Linero again, and since I don't have the warm doublet, I have to wait until I get some other stuff. And I don't need to upgrade those. What about the radiant tides? Oh, right. I need bokoblin guts for those. I should have went and bought some at the Kakariko store. Oh well. Bye. I'm not gonna worry about it, because I'm not gonna be changing off this for a little bit. Whoops, I hit the ZR by mistake. Anyway, so where the Seven Heroines are is like straight east of Gerudo Town. You wanna get there without warping? Yeah, if you wanna get there without warping, there's sand seals. I actually went to Patricia. Told me that you can knock out a sand seal by, detonating a bomb near it. It's a great way to actually get one without having to sneak up on them. Alternatively, of course, you can just jump down from either here or here. But, where's the fun in that? So, let's get this out of the way. Oh yeah, aside from the prep work that I did, I also bought a crap ton of arrows, and a few other things as well. You know, stuff that's not really an easy access of me at the current moment. I also have a flame blade equipped because, as you know, it's the desert. It's not fun. Thankfully, you only get down to low-level cold conditions, so at the very least, as long as I have the flame blade, I should be fine. Also, shield surfing. Alright, let's finally begin this. The Seven Heroines Shrine Quest. What we have to do is, a lot of times, we are actually going to have to climb up the statues and look for these orbs. This is very similar to how you had to do things in the Thundra Plateau. They are also metal, so you need magnesis for these ones, unlike the others. Now, these orbs have symbols on them as opposed to colors. The one we're looking for... well... you'll find the same symbol on the statue. That's where the orb goes. There are 7 orbs total, and you get the rest. You should be able to tell which one's which. I think from looking... there's a tell somewhere. I know there is. Which one, though, which one is the tell? I don't know. Anyway, this is a great step up from having to constantly stop and rest after using up so much stamina. And since our stamina recovers pretty fast, it's like barely any trouble at all. Watch the overhangs. Ah, right here. So, the symbol is actually just above the breast of the statue. So, look for the symbol there and place the orb where it belongs. Like I said, this is very tedious as well because of how long you have to do this. If you don't have the climbing gear and all that, then alternatively, there's actually quite a lot of scaffolding around the statues. Not on all of them, but almost. It really sucks, though, that you actually have to climb up here to find a... oh. Oh, right, I guess it's not entirely on there. Right, because I can see the symbol on that one's sword. Okay. Okay, so it's either on the sword or on their emblem. Yeah. Or somewhere else. Like I said, it's very tedious. It'd be a better idea to just get the orbs off the statues that are, you know, kind of high up. And go from there. As you see here, because it's late. Oh yeah, there is a shrine over there. I have that one marked, by the way. I will be doing that one at some point. Probably not right now, maybe a little bit later. Oh. And up there too. So like I said, this is pretty tedious. Now, do you have an orb up here, or is yours placed near the bottom? Yep. Nope. Yours might be near the bottom. Huh. Like I said, this is gonna be very boring, people. Very boring, very tedious, but I wanna get this one knocked out. Believe me. I know how much of a pain this one was. I'm just trying to check and see if there's anything else around here. Oh man, there's more luminous stones over there. I could quickly get those. Nah. I'll be alright. I'll be fine. I've got like plenty of luminous stones as it is. Alright, that's where that first orb I found goes. I haven't practiced this at all, people, so, if it doesn't look like I know what I'm doing, yeah. Oh, the symbol can even be down there. Huh. So I think I've essentially checked all the statues. Now I just need to figure out which symbol is, which. That was close. Alright. Now, this one that's already in here, I believe, is actually not meant to go in there. Yeah, it's a fake out. Where the symbol, though, is right there. Or was it? I don't remember putting it in there. Okay, so there's that. I guess alternatively, if I don't want to use the climbing gear, I can put the sand boots on. Yeah, never mind, I guess it is in the right... Could be, might not be, I don't know. I would like there to actually be more of a tell. Like, if you put it in the right spots, have it glow or something, I don't know. Alright, that one does not go there. Oh yeah, I keep forgetting. I should shield surf. And you are the one that goes in there. Actually, I wonder if I go faster, yeah, I think I actually go the same speed if I'm carrying something with magnesis. Alright, and you. Where did you have your symbol? Was it... It's not down there. Oh, right, it was up there. At least I can see it. Can I just say how much I really love shield surfing, especially with the ancient shield? Oh, and this one's sword broke. It broke. Huh. Well, if I get this done quick, yay. I really want this one done quick. Alright, now this is the one I was looking at that was up there, and, that's not the one I want. That one goes in another spot. This one, however, I believe actually does go here. If not, though, I'll just have to quickly check over and see what's what. You know what? Just so I do speed this up, I'm gonna put sand boots on. Where are they? Here they are. Here they are. Don't any speed up dishes. Do I? I don't believe I do. I don't. Oh well. That's okay. What? Why wouldn't I go over the edge? Here, I guess. Yeah, that looks like it. Alright, you. I saw where yours went. Yours had the symbol, yours had the symbol on the sword, I believe. Oh, wait, no. Wrong one. Wrong one! Maybe I should get the camera out, because then I can actually, zoom in a little better. Right there! So, are you guys bored yet? I know. I don't like this either. I really don't. Alright. I know there was one. I know there's one more around here. Which one have I not put this one in yet? That one's got one. And that. Looks like this one doesn't, but I don't know. Yep. Here it goes. Now the question is that all seven? Oh, it is! Oh man, I didn't think I'd actually finish it this fast! Yeah, like I said, I only done this shrine quest one time before, and that was on the Wii U version. Whew! The seven heroines! Complete! Korsh Ohu Shrine. Let's go in. And it's a blessing shrine. Thank God. That means I can actually get the, I can get the orb and get out. Once again, I don't know what to do. Oh, but the flame spear I have. The durability up plus. Ah! I don't know. I don't know. I like the flame blade. I like this. You know what? No, I'm gonna put a treasure icon here, and I'm gonna come back for this another time. When I feel I want it. But anyway, I've already registered it, pretty much, so I know it's here. Hopefully I'll at least remember. But yeah, I want to save that flame spear for if I lose mine. Because, believe me, flame spears are not that easy to come by. Just like before, I don't know what I'm going to do now. I only plan to get this one done. Whoops. Yeah, I only plan to get this one done, and I wanted to save doing the other Gerudo stuff for another video later on. Ugh, I don't know. I might have an idea. Might. I'm just thinking here, but I'm thinking if I keep one of my flame weapons out, put on my ruby circlet, my snow boots, if I can find them, and head into the highland areas, I can go take care of that one that involves going around the cliffside. If I remember right, it's either along this or around here, but I know you can see it from this stable. Let's take care of that one. It's cliffside etchings. And I'll go in from there. So beam me up, Zelda. Okay, I should probably hurry this up. Oh, wow. Oh, I don't have a flame. Oh, I do. Yeah, I'm like just in the, thankfully, I'm not right at the threshold, but, it's still pretty worrying that it's really cold around here. Then again, I shouldn't be surprised. It is, after all, in the Gerudo territory. Gerudo territory was never exactly, forgiving. Okay, I want to try and get up to there, and then I'm going to jump down. There's Vomito. I will see you pretty damn soon, Meadow. Oh, hey, there's a croc thing there. You know what? I'm tempted to knock that out. My English. How many times have I done that? Hi, Frosh. How many times have I just essentially killed my English? I swear, the royal bow at this point is almost the most common bow that I'm gonna be finding. I don't know if I feel like going after a Farash item right now. I mean, if I want a Farash item, all I gotta really do is just... I always hate that with these blocks. I get them nice and ready, and then as soon as I try to get them in, the camera will work with me. As soon as I try and get them in... Okay. That works. I swear, that's 5 seeds. Whoa, that's bright. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, guys. That's a little bright. Anyway. The cliffside. The cliffside that I'm looking for. Where is it? I never liked how bright it was out here. I almost want to readjust my, capture settings to lower the brightness and contrast a bit, but I don't know if I should. I mean, I'm kind of working with Shantae as well, and that game's not exactly... I don't really want to mess with it, because I don't know if I'm going to ruin the quality. Now I really need to remember where that cliffside is. Those are pebbets. Boom! Dead. Flint, Rushroom. I don't think I'll ever really need to grab Rushrooms again, because, Fleet Lotus Seeds... Yeah, those are better for me. Yeah, I don't totally remember where that cliffside is. You know what I should have done? Now that I think about it... Well, one is not blow that up. But two is, I should have actually went back to that shrine and placed a pin. Because I feel like I'm going the wrong way. Well, I won't really know unless I actually look. It might be best if I quickly climb up here. Oh, man. Hold on, do I have any, I do! Sorry if I yelled there, I wanted to be absolutely sure I had that. I should probably... I never thought I would need one of these. But you know what? Perfect. So I can quickly climb up here. Regain stamina, and once again, climb back up. Oh man, if the climbing gear didn't look so weird on Link, I would so be wearing this a lot more. Okay. Now, I came up here because it'll give me a great view. Farash? Again? Oh god, that is super bright. Again, I'm sorry, guys. Yeah, I think I might have to adjust the brightness a bit. Oh, hey! I don't care. I don't care. I want something. Give me that horn shard! Where's it going? It's... Farash, thank you so much! Thank you so much, Farash. Oh, man. Oh, man. I love that dragon. That dragon helps me out in so many ways. Okay, let's get my snow boots on, because I'd like to actually get there today. Alright, so I see the horn shard. I hope that's a horn shard. Alright, a little more. And that looks like a horn shard to me. I will gladly take that. I will probably use it for another high-speed dish. Now, if I remember right, what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to get close to this thing. Or something. And then you're supposed to hit it dead center with a shock arrow. Huh. Let me look at the shrine quest thing, because I know I have it. Yeah, that's like really weird. It's supposed to glow blue, if I remember right. Yeah, I don't get it. It's supposed to glow blue. And... wait, isn't... is this one time sensitive? I might have to look into this, because I really don't remember just how... I know I remember I activated it with a shock arrow. I know that much. And I know I'm supposed to hit the target here. Oh! Never mind! I got it! I got it dealt with. I'll take it. I will gladly take that. Because honestly, I do not want to have to get up and go look at my guide. Really don't. Cliffside etchings complete. The Kiha Yug Shrine. Oh. Thank God it's Yug and not Yub, because then that would be a reference to something that was really creepy when I got there in that game. Oh good, it's a blessing shrine, thank God. Kiha Yug's blessing. Okay, what do you have? You have... ooh, diamond. I actually did do a little bit of mining before, once again, I used the Master Sword, because why not? It's just 10 minutes. I can go do a couple things and wait for its power to be restored. But anyway, yeah, I went mining, and I actually did get another diamond. I want to try and get a lot of diamonds. Not just for the, not just to have them, but, you know, they're diamonds. Might be good to have them at some point. So with that, I now have, 5 orbs. Much as I'd like to go and deal with getting the next heart container, I think I'll do that off-screen somewhere and, figure where to go from there. Still, it was nice to finally get that taken care of. That shrine quest was bugging me for the longest time. What else do I have for shrine quests? None. Okay, that's good to know. Because there's none active that I know of right now. Aside from maybe doing the cast ones. And I'm almost tempted. I'm almost tempted to do the cast ones, but the thing is one of them requires a very specific condition. And I can go to where I need to go for that, but I don't know. I also think there's another area that I need to deal with first before I do that. I'll have to look up the cast stuff and see what all I need to do for that. But I do have to get all of his shrine quests done too, and some of them are a little tedious, some of them are quick, and some of them require specific conditions. So anyway, I'm not I'm not totally sure. I'm debating whether to either try for Cass or to take on Eventide Island. It'll be one of the two. So that's really all I have. And I'll probably have another speed-up dish done as well. But, yeah, I'll have to figure things out with the whole Cass thing. If I do, though, I'll have to start setting up conditions so that way I can take care of what I need to take care of. So, until next time, thank you all for watching. If you like this video, please give it a like. If you wish to follow along with some other Let's Plays, please consider subscribing. If any concerns come up, I'll let you guys know my Twitter and additional info in the lower left box of the video and down in the description below. This has been Matt the Speedstar, aka The Gaming Rebel. Now, see you guys next time when we run through the next part of Breath of the Wild.